September the 11th was a day of de-Enlightenment. Politics stood revealed as a veritable Walpurgis Night of the irrational. And such old stuff. The conflicts we now face or fear involve opposed geographical arenas, but also opposed centuries or even millennia, is a landscape of ferocious anachronisms. Nuclear jihad on the Indian subcontinent, the medieval agonism of Islam, the Bronze Age blunderings of the Middle East. We recall that Ronald Reagan habitually anathematized the Soviet Union as godless, meaning, presumably, that its government was secular. This epithet could hardly be unleashed on Osama bin Laden. So Bush, who is religious, and Blair, who is religious, offered the patent falsehood that the war on terrorism was not about religion. Iraq is godless too, but this fact is unlikely to be parlayed just now into another good reason for invading it. The 20th century, with its scores of millions of supernumerary dead, has been called the age of ideology. And the age of ideology clearly was a mere hiatus in the age of religion, which shows little sign of expiry. Since it is no longer permissible to disparage any single faith or creed, let us start disparaging all of them. To be clear, an ideology is a belief system with an inadequate basis in reality. A religion is a belief system with no basis in reality whatever. Religious belief is without reason and without dignity, and its record is near universally dreadful. It is straightforward, and never mind for now about plagues and famines. If God existed, and if he cared for humankind, he would never have given us religion. That was written in June 2002.